And the player to my right here is Mitchell Shanklin. He's a junior for us. And the goalkeeper is Andrew Holt.
Coach, just give us your reaction. You're state champions.
It's a little bit surreal, actually. We focus quite a bit on making sure that the boys play for each other. They don't play for me. They don't play for the fans. They play for each other. And they've done that beautifully all year long.
You've been coach here a long time?
26 years.
Finally get it done. You know, you mentioned that you tell them not to play for you, but did you get the sense that maybe a little bit they were?
No. I don't want them to play for me. I've been very clear that if you're going to play for anybody, you play for your teammates.
Mitchell, just tell us what happened on that goal.
I think it was Sam or Kyle, one of my teammates. He just played it right over top, and one of the defenders just missed the head ball, and I took advantage and I just tapped it in. But I mean, it was there, so I just took it.
On the Riverdale coach, you know, obviously they saw a lot of filming. You guys mentioned that you probably scored half your goals this year in that similar fashion.
Yeah.
What is your kind of mindset when you're in that box and the ball's at your feet?
Well, I mean, most of my goals were just off head balls, and it's just not just soccer that kicks in. I also play basketball, and a lot of basketball, just jumping up, get a rebound. It's just kind of the same concept. Just jump up, head it in, kick it in. It's just same concept, just shooting.
What are the emotions like when you guys are, you know, the clock runs down and it's
just, I'm not just happy for myself, I'm happy for the man next to me. It's just, we're all playing as a team, as a family. And I'm just happy for the man next to me, happy for the coaches, happy for myself, just happy for everybody.
Is it special to be the first in school history? I mean, obviously, you know, that team that you guys just faced has won that game 9 times.
Yeah.
Is it a little more special to know that you guys are the first one and you can always say that you guys are the first?
Yeah, I guess. Yeah. I mean, it's a big deal. It's a really big deal. And I'm just happy I could be a part of it.
Andrew, you guys coming off of an emotional win in the Baltimore County Championship game with the penalty kicks, and then just carried that momentum right into the playoffs. Just talk about the run that this team has been on and how it's been able to be sustained.
It's unreal. I mean, every day of practice, we go hard, but it we joke around a lot. We're brothers on the field. We have fun. That's the most important thing to us, and I think that's what carried us this season. It wasn't the sense of hostility. We were all brothers. We all bonded. No one hated each other. We all got along very well. We would come out focused every game. We knew what we had to get done, and we got it done when we needed to, and it came out in our favor almost every single game.
You guys were bringing in a lot of fresh guys, Coach, you know, especially up top. Was that something you guys have done all season, or is that something you guys were trying to focus on maybe in this game against that back line?
We have a lot of talented players. We didn't go very deep on the bench, but we scrolled them through to make sure they weren't getting too fatigued. It was a bigger field than we're accustomed to. So the work rate was a little bit higher in those key positions of the wing midfielders and the target player. We did that intentionally. I don't think we went more than 3 guys, maybe 4 guys deep on the bench, though. There's plenty of other players that could have contributed, but once we get our kids on the routine, we kind of stay with it. And to dovetail on what Drew stated is that I think one of the reasons that they were ready to play today and not be afraid or nervous is because we've worked very hard for a very long time at establishing a culture of teamwork and friendship and playing for each other. And that takes a little bit of the stress off of the kids to think, oh my gosh, what am I going to do if it doesn't work out? And they just go out and have fun and play as hard as they can. And they trust their teammates day in and day out to the point of selflessness that is difficult for a young man to work through, and it works for these boys.
What do you guys do tactically on the field so well?
Well, we've got the same game plan all year long. We early balls to the wings, use Isaac's speed out there on the left side, use Kai's speed out on the right side, use Mitchell's tenacity and kind of the process that Mitchell goes through where he just gets after it and doesn't really think a lot. He just is kind of like a see ball, get ball kind of mentality for Mitchell. And he's very good at it. He's scored 19 of our 65 goals this year, 66 goals, 19 out of 66 now. And so the plan was to use the wings, break down the defense, try to get behind them, force the defense to chase backwards and then slot the ball across. We didn't get a goal that way today, but we created enough dangerous situations where they were a little bit concerned and kept dropping off, and it allowed us to win them more balls in the midfield.
Yeah, you know, you mentioned you didn't score that way. A lot of both goals were kind of, you know, just balls floating in the box, or, you know, a ball deflected off the head.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it feel like it's kind of maybe meant to be that the ball kind of went your way tonight. You know, I know you guys kind of controlled the game a lot, but to see the two bounces go your way.
Yeah, you know, Drew made that beautiful save diving off to his right side. Not sure if it would have been in or hit the bar, but either way, it takes it deflates the opponent just a little bit when they see that type of save being made. And then they begin to think, well, what do I really have to do? And so little things like that are very important as well.
What's this going to mean at school to the community, to your classmates? I think it's a big deal at Eastern Tech to be state champions in soccer.
Just like you said, well, we're the first Eastern Tech boys soccer team to bring home a state championship, and I guess it's just a really big deal, just not just for the boys, just also for the entire school. Just we get to come home and show them that we pulled it out the whole season.
Yeah, you look at like the Falstons and like the River Hills, who have 10 plus, 30 plus state championships all around. This will be number 7 for our school. So it's a big thing for us to bring that home.
7th appearance for the regions, and second time we're here. The last time we were here was 2004.
No, Pete, you've been saying since the beginning of the season you thought this was the most talented team you've ever had at Eastern Tech. So.
It's relative. We've had talented teams in the past. We had a particularly talented team in early 2000s. I think it was 2001, but it was a different game back then. Everybody was playing on grass. It wasn't as fast. It was a different type of talent, a different type of skill and teamwork that you needed to be effective. On the synthetic surface, these guys do have skill. I haven't really done any technical training with them the whole year. We don't do drills for technical skill because they generally have that already. So everything that we do is just tactical play or free play. And they get along with each other well enough that they do that hard every day. And a lot of that is a tribute to the kids who did not play today. Because that second group of boys, they're pretty darn good soccer players, so that when our first team goes up against them in our 40-minute scrimmage or whatever we're going to do, if the first team doesn't watch it, they're going to get their tails kicked. And so a lot of the benefit is what the second group of boys have done to make the first team of boys even better each and every day.
You guys have any plans to celebrate tonight? Any special meals or?
No, we had a big ZD lunch in the middle of the day. That was a lot of fun. Couple of soccer moms put that together, and after school we were a little bit more prudent, had some fruit, more fruit, a little bit of bread and butter, and bread and peanut butter, and yeah. Now it's too late for them to, hopefully they go home and do their darn homework.
Maybe you get a pass tonight. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time.